Well, thank you for watching Inland Empire live on IEMG. You know, we've also got IE Media Group YouTube, and you can check out all the shows. Great programming on YouTube right now. And all you got to do is hit that subscribe button for us. It's absolutely free, and it will take you about 3 seconds. Check out all the great local programming right here on IEMG on the IE Media Group YouTube channel. And welcome back to Inland Empire Alive on IEMG. We're talking about Pathways from Boys to Men. A couple of the board members from Pathways from Boys to Men here joining us are Linda Patterson and Oren Dontignac.
Yes, sir.
Is that close?
That's you. Good enough.
Right on it.
Oren and Erlinda joining us here because, again, this is the holiday season, and there's so many people, so many local groups that are giving back. And we want to kind of bring a shine a light on those programs.
Absolutely.
You guys have been doing this for a long, long time. And Oren, you were telling me when the cameras were off that, what, 14 years
14
now?
14 years. Yes, sir. 14 years.
How did Pathways from Boys to Men start?
Well, James Randolph, he's the founder of it. It was a vision of his. He was very passionate about helping people. And he came up with this idea about, you know, trying to do something for the community. And, you know, it just took off, you know. And ever since, you know, he's been recruiting people like myself and Erlinda. And we've just been going forward. And every year we've been getting more and more involved in different things pertaining to it. And mm-hmm. we've expanded so much. And you know, this we're here today. Now, 14 years later.
Yeah, 14 years strong, yeah. Right?
Yes.
Erlinda, let me ask you, as we get kind of to the nuts and bolts, and this is more of a wide open question, but we can kind of dial it in here about what sure. exactly you guys do at Pathways from Boys to Men, because you're really uplifting, supporting, encouraging, and empowering, right?
Absolutely.
A local community that needs Pathways from Boys to Men.
Right. There's this population out here
yeah.
that does not know how to be interviewed. They don't know how to dress. They have anger management issues that are needed. You know, they need training for these things. A lot of them are people who have come from, let's say, prison or mm-hmm. a bad reputation, a bad history, and a lot of people won't help them. So Pathway from Boys to Men gives them that opportunity. They come in, they have trainings, and they become certified. They have the classes mm-hmm. that teach them communication skills, teach them anger management skills. So, and many other, you know.
Yeah, many other crafts. We offer many types of training. Plumbing, welding,
construction, yes.
Technical classes mm-hmm. We offer, you know, just a wide range, you know. We try to, you know, as, you know, the people show up,
yeah.
you know, we try to find out what he or she, you know, may be good at or may, you know, may be interested in, and then we try to get them involved in whatever program they select. And whichever way we can to give yeah. them something to get out there right. to stand a chance.
So you're giving them skills for a job, but you're also telling them how to, or educating them how to go into a job interview.
Absolutely. Yes.
Wear a tie,
yes.
You know, sit up straight, look them in the eye, those right. sorts of things, right, Oren?
That's correct, absolutely.
And Erlinda, I wanted to ask you too, because in the name it's From Boys to Men, but it's not just men, correct?
No, well, it's when he started 14 years ago, uh-huh. James Randolph, the director, when he started 14 years ago, he just started with the project From Boys to Men and then evolved yeah. into bringing the women in to the program. So if we say Pathway from Boys to Men, it's open still to the other population as mm-hmm. well.
Yeah.
You know, getting back to jobs and training, we also network and work with other groups. For instance, we work with a construction company, mm-hmm. a union, and yeah. we get them involved in training mm-hmm. with that union, construction union, so that they can, you know, they can have a life that's decent.
Yeah.
You know, in construction, they can earn as much as $1 per minute.
That's a good living.
That's a very good yeah. living.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, these are people that are living out in the streets. or in their homes and making $12, $11 an hour.
Yeah.
I mean, with rents and food the way it is right now, there's no way they can survive.
Yeah.
So we are helping them to have a better life.
Well, we've got more to get to with you
yes.
guys. We're going to take a quick break. More with Pathway from Boys to Men when we come back here on IEA.
Today we're at the site of the Camp Cajon Monument, the newly dedicated Camp Cajon Monument, which is being dedicated today to commemorate the 100-year anniversary of the original dedication on July 4th, 1919. Is this not a beautiful monument? As many of you know, today is the 100-year anniversary of the opening of Camp Cajon, a free public rest stop constructed on National Old Trails Road and opened on July 4th, 1919.
Well, back in 1919, it was along what was known as the National Old Trails Road. And basically what we're standing on right now is part of that. Well, it's close proximity to the National Old Trails Road, which was the predecessor for Route 66.
John has written many books about Camp Cajon and the Cajon Pass. And back in 2016, I was reading one of his books about Camp Cajon, and it inspired me to consider a monument and 100th anniversary of the dedication here today on July 4th, 2019. I initially thought of a plain and simple monument, but after running it by Mark, he said, let's build a replica of the original.
The monument that you see here today is not an exact duplicate, but it's a very close replica of the original monument with the exact text that was on the original monument, so that you can see what the folks were thinking during that time, the type of poetry they used, the type of wording that they used in their poems and so forth. And the monument here is really going to show folks what travel was like on early National Old Trails Road and Route 66.
The site itself is there's so much history that has gone on in the Cajon Pass. Going through this little narrow canyon, which is just south of the monument, is where the old Spanish trail came through. This is originally it was an Indian trail, and then later on it was used for mule caravans come from New Mexico.
That 4th of July was especially sweet because America's soldiers had just returned home from World War I a few months earlier, and their families were reunited and filled with patriotism. We spent almost 2 years getting the permitting complete and $3,000 on permitting fees between the Forest Service and the county. That was a challenge, but it was a process we had to go through to build on Forest Service land. They helped us through the whole process. They were very gracious and worked with us, and same thing with the county.
People coming through, it was a safe haven. It was a wonderful respite for the motorists coming across the Mojave Desert, a place where they could stop, they could camp out, they could have food, they could just relax. And also the people living in San Bernardino Valley can also come up here and picnic.
And welcome back to IEA, talking with Pathway from Boys to Men. And Orin, something I wanted to ask you, because there's various populations in our community that could use something like this. And you mentioned off camera, even homeless individuals, people experiencing homelessness, could use Pathway from Boys to Men to maybe find that career, find those skills to land that job interview or whatnot, mm-hmm. correct?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Like I say, we try to reach out to everyone.
Yeah.
You know, we started in one place, like I say, at back 14 years ago. I mean, obviously the things that are going on now today wasn't quite that bad back mm-hmm. then. So since then, you know, we have grown a lot. A lot of things have changed. So we try to reach out to anyone. It doesn't matter if you're homeless. Doesn't matter if you just, you know, you have convictions, if you just got out of prison.
Yeah.
You know, we try to reach out to anyone. Anyone that comes to us, we do whatever we can.
And I can turn them away.
Yeah,
help
we don't
them,
turn
right?
anyone away.
Right.
No one, no matter what.
And Erlinda, you know, with that, helping anyone who walks in those doors, I asked you, well, what's the age range? And you said basically everyone, right? Teenagers senior citizens, I guess?
Senior citizens,
yeah.
Of course. I've been in board meetings where people walk in as well,
uh-huh.
and they're hungry. So we feed them.
Absolutely.
And it could be someone, you know, that, like we said, a homeless individual mm-hmm. that's 65 years old. And then when he realizes and listens and hears that this program exists, you know, there's opportunity. Cleaning floors.
Yeah.
I mean, we can find them a job. And not only that, we help find them a bed as well.
Yeah.
So that they don't stay out in the cold. You know, one of the things that I would like to share is that we also, as I said to you earlier, we like to give them a little gift around the holidays.
Yes.
And we are having a toy drive or gift drive on the 21st of December. And we would love for people to join us and be in part mm-hmm. of giving
Absolutely.
To this particular population that is greatly in need.
If people want to donate, if people want to donate their time,
yes.
if people want to get involved, How do they go about contacting Pathway from Boys to Men?
Okay, there's a phone number, and it is the phone number to James Randolph.
Okay.
Okay, and it's 909-838-5623.
Okay.
Leave a message, and he will get back with you. And, you know, you can change one person's attitude and give them, you know, encouragement that someone cares. Because, you know, a lot of times their morale is low.
Yeah.
And we want to yes. boost the self-esteem, you know. We want to help them out.
Well, you guys are certainly doing good work, and we appreciate you taking time to join us on the show to kind of share what you guys are doing in our local community, because it is impactful. So we do appreciate your time, Erlinda and Oren. Thank you very much.
And thank you
You're
very
welcome.
Much.
Appreciate it.
You got it. We'll be right back here on Inland Empire Alive on IEMG. Well, thank you for watching Inland Empire Alive on IEMG. You know, we've also got IE Media Group YouTube, and you can check out all the shows. Great programming on YouTube right now. And all you got to do is hit that subscribe button for us. It's absolutely free, and it will take you about 3 seconds. Check out all the great local programming right here on IEMG on the IE Media Group YouTube channel.